how to add seam allowance to your pattern pieces. You'll want to make sure you switch tools to the seam allowance tool, and then you'll just click and drag over all the pattern pieces you want to add seam allowance to, and it will add a default amount of seam allowance, which is 0.394 inches, because I'm working in inches. That might be a more round number in the metric system, I'm not sure. But anyways, after you do that, it has only one pattern piece selected. See how one's yellow? It did add seam allowance to the other one, but for some reason, it doesn't leave everything selected because I want to change it to 0.5. But before I do, I should reselect everything. I really don't know why it doesn't automatically select everything. I don't know. Maybe there's a helpful reason. But now I can see it's all selected. It's all yellow, so I can change it in my property editor from 0.394 to half an inch, which is 0.5. And then for the hems, I usually like the hems to be a little bit longer, so I'm going to hold shift and select them individually. I'm working on the half scale, so I only need to select half of it, and I can change it to 1 inch. There you are. Now you'll see the darts have just half an inch of seam allowance selected. If you wanted the seam allowance, you know, that doesn't get cut out and can be folded over, you can do that. So again, make sure you're in the seam allowance tool and just click the point of the dart tip, and then go ahead and look under intersection and see how they have the little dart seam allowance options. And you can either have the seam allowance folded towards the left or folded towards the right. So there you go. And now you have seam allowance added as if you were to just, you know, fold them together and fold over the seam allowance. So I hope that answers your guys' seam allowance questions. And I look forward to seeing those projects turned in and looking good.